the signs were already there. Before I'd used drugs and alcohol, I'd gone to university, I'd started my personal hygiene habits had already started to erode, and I wasn't looking after myself at the age of 16, 17. So prior to using any alcohol and drugs, that pattern had already been set. So by the time I picked up cannabis, I think all it did was amplify the existing unwellness that exists, that was there, that was present.
I did have a little list of mental illnesses that diagnosed me with from taking drugs. It was amphetamine-induced psychosis and cannabis-induced psychosis. They said I had bipolar disorder. They said I had suspicion for being prodromal with paranoid schizoid defective disorder.
I felt like I'd been running around with lots of big blindfolds on. I also felt like I didn't really know anyone around me either. Like everyone had been running around wearing big masks. And I mean, I'd certainly been wearing a big mask, pretending that I was fine. And I really wasn't behind it.
I'd been to the doctor to say I was depressed, and so she'd given me, I'm trying to remember what it was now, it's quite a common one that they give. And so I'd taken it, and she said, don't drink or take anything with it. But I did. So I drank, and I think I took E, and I think I took speed with it, or K or something. Ended up lying down, screaming into a pillow, just stuffing it all into my mouth, and screaming and screaming and screaming for hours, and then getting a razor and cutting my arms. Because the anguish and the turmoil and the pain was so great that I didn't know how else to let it out.
You know, you think about it for a week, so you stay up for 7 days, and you get stoned in that first morning, and you get stoned at night time, but you don't go to sleep, and you get stoned the next morning, the next day time. You're actually stoned for a week, and then your body loses touch with reality, and you start thinking things that aren't true. And every now and then I like get a little bit like that, you know? It's just paranoia and shit, and having you know, just fucked up thoughts about shit that's not true.
You know, once you're better, people want you to be better all the time. And it's really hard to be better all the time, because I'm not better all the time, better most of the time.
Despite the fact that I had no sense of personal hygiene, no sense of once again, that I was dying. I was probably depressed, but didn't really know that I was depressed. Yeah, once again, lost and aimless. Yeah, if I had have had a clinical diagnosis, they probably would have given me depression and substance dependence, definitely. But I wouldn't have known either of those things at the time.